Hello and welcome to the Xbox 360. I got a capture card. We can have Xbox 360 content on the channel now. So I don't know how good this mic is that I'm using because my Xbox One mic doesn't work. But so I hope that there's no like background audio or anything. But if there is, I'm sorry about that. And again, if there is, I will try to get another mic for it, like a better mic for this. But anyways, you would think, since we're on Xbox 360 now, the most logical thing to go to is Forza Motorsport 4. Not quite yet. Instead, we are gonna head over to Forza Horizon 2 on the 360. I'm now realizing I'm kind of sounding like AR-12 right now. That's not a side effect of the Elgato, right? Am I starting to, like, to me it sounds like I'm talking like AR-12. So let me try to talk more how I normally talk then. So immediately you already notice the difference. It sounds like the beats are already kicked up in the start screen music. Usually this takes some time on the Xbox One. But something you do notice, why does the game look so good? I mean, why does it look like the Xbox One version? And that is because cutscenes in this game were ripped straight from the Xbox One. So that creates a problem. Would the cutscenes look better than the game itself? So, and that also shows cars that aren't in the game, like the Ram Runner in the opening cutscene, that's not in the game, so. Anyways, let's get started off here. You will notice something when we jump in that I am gonna kind of point out, and I just hope nothing really happens with it because, yeah, there is something I am gonna kind of point out to you guys when we load in. Okay, I think you already see it. Yeah, I think you do already see it. So, first of all, I modded the traffic cars in, but we're going to play around with these later. And second off, I have almost a billion credits. So yeah, I may have modded the game. Not because I don't want to play it, but, well, actually, that is kind of the reason. It's just because I don't want to, like, I don't really want to go ahead and, I've already played through this game before, so.
All right, dude. Let me know what you need.
Yeah, the garage, you can already see it's different. Like, this is, oh my god. Okay, well, first off, Ford Fiesta ZTEC S. This, if you don't remember, this was, it was in, like, the 360 Motorsport titles, like, Forza 3, Forza 4. I don't know if it was in anything before that. But then in Horizon 1, this thing was a unicorn car. It, as you can see, it is modified. Here in Horizon 2, it's actually in the base game. So, like, here in Horizon 2, it's in the base game. Which doesn't make sense because it's not in the base game. Like, it's not in the game. It's not in the base game in the Xbox One version. So this is actually something the game does. The game has that Horizon 2 on the Xbox One doesn't. See, anyways, I think you can already tell like a difference in like the graphics and stuff. Obviously, they don't look as good as the One version, because of the You know, because, I mean, we're on the Xbox 360.
Hey, don't be shy. Come on in.
But, Like, also, another, like, there's some things that this game has that the one version doesn't. Like, as you can see on this 2012 Dodge Charger, we have the push bar on it. I don't know why, but this push bar, well, like, we have the push bar, we have, like, the modifications that make it look like, well, like, an SXT or whatever, except with, like, a little wing on the back. So, but then, like, we don't have this in the Xbox One version. This is just something that carried over from Horizon 1 on the 360. You can also see the little icons seem to float in the air like that. That's something I think works in, like, the Crew and... because, like, the Crew had that too. I don't know if the Crew 1 still has that, but I know it was like that in the base game. But, like, it has... like, that worked in, like, the Crew, and it works in Need for Speed Heat for the garages. I don't really think it works too well in this game. Also, you can see that the sun does look really good in this because... I mean, it's based off of Horizon 1. Yeah, what do you call it? The bucket list. They're actually, like, the old outposts. I don't know. This game just feels like... it feels like its own game. I mean, it is still the worst Horizon. Like, by far. Like, the 360 version of Horizon 2, it is still the worst Horizon. If you were to actually consider different versions as, like, part of, like, which ones are the worst, which ones are not. But, yeah. Another problem with this game is, it uses the same voice line as the one. So they talk about online free roam. There is no online free roam. If I go over to social... no, not social. If I go over to... there's only online road trip. There's no online free roam. So here we come over here, and this is actually something I really like about this. But I don't know why this is not in the Xbox One version. You can actually drive down into the Castelletto hub. I have no idea why this is not in the Xbox One version. This is, like, I like being able to drive down it like that.
Hey there, stranger.
Okay, yeah, so I'm getting into traffic. Again, we'll play more around with the traffic cars later. But I'm getting into traffic car right now because I want to head over to somewhere. Auto Aspera. You know what? Actually, no. Let's get into one of my other cars.
Hey, how's things?
You know, we should still be able to make it there in this. Hold on. I mean, the highway is, like, right there. I want to head over to the Abbey because, yes, you can. Yes, you can go to the Abbey in this game.
In 100 yards.
Which is surprising because of how restricted this game is. Like, compared to, like, Horizon. Compared to, like, Horizon 2 on the...
turn around.
On the Xbox One and stuff. I really don't know why the traffic cars are designed like this. So, like, the traffic cars are designed like... they're designed like the player cars. But they're only being driven around the map at, like, 30 miles per hour, so why are they... it's almost like they want people to be able to mod these in, which... which I am hoping that once, because, like, the Series X, even though it is kind of an Xbox now, even though it is kind of an Xbox One, no, you can think of it. Even though it is kind of an Xbox One, oh yeah, there's no interior. Even though the Series X kind of looks like a super powerful Xbox One variant, apparently it's really not. It's new console and all that. So maybe as that starts to come out, maybe as Xbox One starts to die down, maybe the modding will come out for that, and we'll be able to like mod like Horizon 4 and all that. Which, I mean, those games I wouldn't mind to have crazy amounts of money, because, like, I...
400 yards.
Oh, my! Right. Okay, that's one of this, this one, that's one of this game's problems. Oh, my God, I am dead as shit. But,
turn right.
But... maybe, like, you know, traffic on modding will come in or something. It's... I'm not sure. Yeah, the reason I am in a traffic car is because what we're about to do, we need a really quiet idle to hear it best. So, like, that's why I'm in this right now. That's why I'm in the Brera. Yeah, this is considered the worst Horizon, but I actually still really like it. I feel like they did do a good job. Like, I feel like they did do a really good job on this one. I mean, apparently Playground didn't actually make the port for Xbox 360. Like, the Xbox 360 port is made by Sumo Digital. So that's why if you actually watch through the, like the intro logos and all that, you won't find a Playground logo. You'll just find, like, a Tone 10... like Sumo Digital, I'm pretty sure Dolby Digital is in there. But yeah, they still did a really good job on this game. I mean, is it shitty compared to every Horizon that's ever existed? Yeah, it's shitty by a long shot. But at the same time, though, they did do a really good job on this for what it is. Like, you can tell that they did not really slouch much with this. Because, like, sometimes that happens with ports where, like, the company kind of just slouches, tosses it together, which is almost kind of like what this game is, but at the same time, it actually does feel like it has something to it. It feels like it actually had stuff put into it. It actually feels like a Horizon. But, like, it still feels like Horizon. It still feels like it still feels really good. And you know what, maybe later on in this game we'll hop on to the Fast and Furious thing, because I do have Fast and Furious on the 360. I just never got it on the One because of how I, you know, because of how, like, I've already played it on here. So maybe we'll hop on that later. I'm not sure. Yeah, but guys, like, if you think about it, technically this is the last Forza game where you can drive a Brera. They really need to bring the Brera back. I wouldn't say they absolutely need to. I don't think a lot of people would need to kind of do it.
Turn left.
I just love the Brera for some reason. Like, of course, there's better alphas, But this is actually this little hatchback thing. This is actually one of my favorite. I wouldn't say my absolute favorite Alpha. That would probably actually have to go to the Julia Quadrifoglio. But
you have arrived.
Well, that would probably have to go to like that, or maybe like an older Alpha or something. But yeah, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna shut off my radio. And then I'm going to mute my mic. And you might have already heard it, but I'm just going to let you sit and listen for a minute. So, yeah, guys, yeah, you know how, so you know how Horizon 1 on the Xbox One, like, had those, no, not Horizon 1, what am I saying? You know how Horizon 2 on the Xbox One had those, like, removed, like, Ghost of the Abbey sounds. But that turned out to actually be just, like, a fox. Yeah, those are still back then. Like, those are actually, like, you could, like, if you didn't hear them, go back. Like, go back in the video. You can still hear them back there on the 360. Because the 360 version only got updated once. And that was to, fix a money glitch this game had. So yeah, I think you do see like a glaring issue I have with right now. Oh, let's actually head over here. Oh wait, no, I forgot I can switch cars on the fly. Yeah, you can actually switch cars on the fly in this. I'm not getting in my spin mobile. Yes, I modded the bonfires into my garage, I know. Let's get into my fake Z06, because, yeah, we never got any, like, DLC cars in this game or anything, so that's, like, the one thing that really sucks about it. But yeah, if you go over here, you can see where the festival is on the Xbox One. There's just a little house there. And the reason for that is because for some reason, on here, the festival is... Oh yeah, and also, surprisingly, you can still drive through here on this version. Because, like, there's so many of these, like, little passageways, passageways and stuff that you can't pass through. But for some reason, on the Xbox 360, the festival's over here. And while it is kind of smaller, I do gotta say, I like this location better. I actually like this spot for the festival a lot better. I actually like that spot a lot better. Of course, we can't go in it because we don't have... Because, like, I never progressed in the story on here yet. Oh yeah, but you can see though, it's got the camera shake. I don't know if this is a thing. I forgot if this is a thing in the Xbox One version or not. But I do like the camera shake. Yeah, you can see the game is a little bit more restricted than usual. I mean, you can still go off phone, so wait, how close is this to the golf course? Okay, yeah, you see, like, the golf course is right behind us, somewhere. Right? It's like to our left. Yeah, see, there's the golf course over there. But if you want to go in it, you can't. It's walled off. Now, I feel like the purpose for this was because of... Then there's a less solid map, which means there's more data. There's a less solid map, which means that there's less that the game has to process right now. So, yeah, you couldn't go into the golf course in this game. On the Xbox 360 version, you couldn't. Yeah, you just couldn't. I mean, there is a little driveway for it over here. But I mean, as you can see, you drive into the driveway and it's just walled off. Which I actually like the look of the walls. I do actually wish that they kept the walls in the one version. But then of course I had the gates open so that you can go into the golf course. Thank you. Yeah, coming in into coming into Nisio, I don't think there was really much different with it, but there is something that I do remember that I do want to check out. Well, I mean, firstly, something that is different is there's no Storm Island thing over here, obviously, because, I mean, there is no Storm Island on the 360. And also, wait, hold on, are these vehicles breakable? Okay, yeah, those lampposts are breakable. But if I remember correctly, if we come over here, there should be one that is. There should be one over here that's like. If I remember correctly. Yep, there's a floating one. I remember this one. I remember you. And like most cars drive under it, but like say like if you're in a Jeep Wrangler, it just like squats you down under it. You know what, hold on, I think I do have a big vehicle I can use. Not the Kenworth. Give it a transit. Sure, try the transit. And I guess V6, like I guess that the base, like that the base engine sound for when there isn't an engine sound in this game is a V6, because this thing sounds like a V6, but this thing is a transit diesel, so. I guess V6 is just like the bass sound or whatever. This thing actually, like in Horizon 4, you can hear this thing's like diesel. Yep. This one, because it's floating, it's unbreakable, so. Never mind, if you hit it hard enough, it's breakable. Yeah, so this was the Nice Messina Festival. You could come like over here and be like behind the pit. I don't know if you can actually do this in the on the one version. I'm gonna have to check this out because I don't think you can actually do this on the one. But yeah, I don't think you actually can. I'll go and look, but I don't think you can actually drive food in. On the one. Yeah, other than that, you can see that this is pretty much the same festival and stuff, but something I do want to try really quick.
Yo, bud, how's things?
We can just buy a car right on the fly. See, we do have the Ford Raptor in this game, but again, there's not really much off-roading in this, so why bother? it's a Raptor, why not? I forgot we had the MO2 in this game. I always forget that we have the MO2 in this game. Oh yeah, stuff is sorted by class, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, it's all sorted by class. Okay, you know, no, let's actually buy this really quick. I knew this was in the game, but. Oh, what? That's cool. It never said Cobra on top. Oh, that's cool. Why don't they do that anymore? I'm not talking about Ford, I'm talking about... This is Cobra on the steering wheel. I mean, Cobra on the steering wheel, I'm pretty sure it still says that, just not a sprite. It doesn't say Cobra on the windshield anymore. I like that. Maybe they got rid of it because you can't see it from the inside or something. I want to see if this works. Okay, no. See, stuff like that, they actually did. Oh my god. Oh, I forgot we had the old damage models in this game. Is that the old damage model? Yeah, that's the old damage model. I forgot we had that in this game. Anyways, let's retro back to the festival. I just so we can travel around a little bit quicker. Oh my god. Yeah, but saying Cobra on the windshield like that, I didn't... Like, that's not in any other Forza. I'm pretty sure this was the first Forza with the Cobra R, right? Or with this Cobra R? Right? If I'm not, like, just cracking... Oh, I'm going the wrong way. Actually, no, I want to get up to Montalino, so... With Montalino or whatever I'm talking, so...
Hey, Serena. We be pushing up.
I really like this Sphinx interior. Got on here because of the fencing, you can't just get... Oh, never mind, maybe you can. Yeah, I don't know why, there's some fencing in this game that really doesn't make any sense, like we got this fence here, but I'm pretty sure you can go in there if you go around. Oh no, I guess you can't. Okay. But like this area right here to my right, at some point over there, there's a solid fence, but then you can just go around it and go to the other side of it, so... I don't really see the point of it. Oh yeah, this is definitely the old damage model. So yeah, here's the Montalino festival. See, it's a lot smaller. You can go out here, but I think there is a fence. Yeah, see, there's a fence. Normally, in the Xbox One version, you can continue going in that way. In this, there's a fence. But I'm pretty sure, like, what road was it? Okay, I think I see the road. First of all, break the wall, home. lenses again. But I'm pretty sure it's this road, right? Yeah, this road for some reason gets like really bumpy at some point. Oh, there it is. Over here, over here. No? Yeah, you can go in here. You can go in here, but I don't think any of, like, the building jumps work or anything. I mean, there's a fence around the place, so you can't get no speed form anyways. What was the really bumpy road in Montalino? I know there was just like a really bumpy road here. I think it's that one to our right. Oh, here's next. I know there's just like one road in this area that's just like really bumpy on the 360. It's this road. It's the one we were just on. And this one. I'm not sure why it does this. I'm not sure what causes this. I still love that, says Copa on the windshield. I actually do hope at some point we do get window stickers just so I can put Copa on the windshield again. I like that. I mean, if this thing wasn't a Cobra, that would be ricey, but it's a Cobra R. So I kind of like it. Ow.
All this. In your face. Horizon Base Arena.
Oh, that did not go well. I need to like more speed or less angle now. Yeah, Castelletto, something really weird. Ow, ow. Something really weird is this road here. Because, like, this road on the Xbox 360, it's all paint. But on the Xbox One, it's all paint. On the Xbox 360, it changed. Wait, what? Did I get the wrong road? Wait. Oh, I'm on the wrong road. Oops, never mind, I'm on the wrong road. Oh, but I can show something that the Xbox 360 has over the Xbox One version over here. So, yeah, on the Xbox One version, you come over here, you can look out and, like, see... Like, you can look out past this barrier, like, by doing this, and then look under the map. In this, you can. I don't know, there's like certain areas where of course this game is just not really polished, and then there's certain areas where it's actually more polished than Xbox One. I don't know. Also, yeah. Oh yeah, but you see, like, there's this little tunnel here, you can't go in it in this. Again, probably to save space on assets. I do really like the look of the fireworks on the 360, though. Again, I love that you can drive down here. I love this. At some point in the game, you have to road trip back to here, and it just gets all like jam packed on here. Oh yeah, also the docks. I'm just not going to the docks because like you know what? Screw it. Let's take a nice little trip to the docks. Why not?
Dude, how's things?
Oh, I forgot. I forgot.
Hey man,
I forgot if you weren't gonna buy the car right from the menu here, you gotta buy it from. Like, you gotta buy it actually at the auto show. So let's get a P1. See. Yeah, let's get the P1 out. Turn to pause me. Oh, yeah, you can see that the auto show and stuff. It's like the Horizon 1 auto show. And also, if I go into the garage here, because I know I haven't actually gone into the garage yet. If I go to either upgrades or paint shop, it's actually going to bring me into the Horizon 1 version of it. Yeah. Of course, modified and all that. You got like the people outside and stuff, which... Also, you do have the new Forza customization for this. See, a lot of cars on this version have... the old Forza customization, like the old Xbox 360 stuff, but if it's a car that was never in an Xbox 360 title, it has the Xbox One Forza customization. Oh, that is something that this game has over Horizon 2 on the one though. Like when you change your tire width, it actually moves the disc and also like stretches the wheel like that. I like that. That's something this game has over the Xbox One version. What this game doesn't have over the Xbox One version is the wheel menu. Yeah, leave garage.
Hey, man.
Hey, Hey, one benefit over the one. I don't have to worry about accidentally clicking the Storm Island thing when I go over the settings. Oh, this thing's quiet. Oh yeah, something I really like though. Hold on. Let me just shut off the music. That is quiet. But something I do like, because McLaren P1, rear-wheel drive, it's like rear-wheel drive, 900 horsepower, right? Unless we up the horsepower. I forgot if we did any engine upgrades already. Okay, no, it's still stock. 903 horsepower. You expect it to spin its wheels. But then when we hit the gas, it doesn't. And that's because with this version, if you chuck race tires on some, like with the Xbox One version, not the one, with the Xbox 360, now, the Xbox 360 version is a lot more arcadey than, oh yeah, that road before where I was saying it's like dirt instead of pavement, it's this road right here. For some reason, it's dirt instead of pavement. Now, oh yeah, that's something that looks a lot better on this version is the flames. You can spin it again. Spit the flame. Yeah, the flames look the best on like Horizon 1 and Horizon 2 on the 360 and all that. Like that's when the flames look the best with Forza. But like, obviously because this is like a more arcadey Forza, I mean, the Horizon series is always kind of arcadey. I mean, now it's kind of like a mix of realistic and arcade. I mean, it's still like a mix of realistic and arcadey, but like Horizon 1 and Horizon 2 was a lot more arcadey, but this was definitely the most arcadey Horizon out of all of them. Well, along with Horizon 1, of course, but, so this one, you chuck race tires on something, it just grips and goes. Like, you chuck race tires on something, it'll most likely corner decently. And it just, like, you step on it. Come on, like, look. And it just goes. Like, it just grips and goes. You get, like, a little bit of wheel spin, but it still just grips and goes. Wait! Hold on. Hold on, I'm gonna mute my mic and turn up the game volume for you guys. Hold on, like, hold the phone. I'm amazed right now. Forza Horizon 1. When you went like really fast, when you were going like really fast, there was a wind rushing noise. That's in this version. That is, from what I know, that is not on the Xbox One version. I mean, I'm gonna recheck it later. I'm gonna recheck everything later. But from what I know, that is not in the Xbox One version and not in Horizon anymore. How is it in the crappiest Forza? Holy crap, this game does have some stuff over the one version. We'll be right back. Oh yeah, since this car was from Forza 5, does it have the newer Crash model on it? Since it's from Forza 5. No, it looks like it still has the old one, yeah. This one has the old Crash model. Surprising. Oh, but you don't have the little section we could fall off over here. Oh, you don't have the little like burger stand or pizza stand or whatever it was there. Oh, and you don't have like all the things on the beach or anything. Yeah, but you'll see, like, driving along here, all of a sudden you start seeing all of whatever this is, which I don't remember those actually being there on the one version, so I don't know why they're here. But then that all leads up to the entrance to the docks, which is blocked off by Horizon gates. Which also, it's really weird that they fenced up all down there and stuff, so... And if we go into photo mode, I think you are able to see the docks from here. No, you can't because you can't lift the camera up high enough. Okay, yeah, you can see the docks from up here. Yeah, you see, it's like you don't see any like shipping containers or anything. Because you can't go down there. You just can't, like, from the looks of it, the road's even gone. Like, past that, no, okay, no, it just comes in there. Wait, I could probably do photo mode from here. Okay, no, the road does keep going. It probably ends. Yeah, it looks like the road just ends. It looks like it ends into the side of the wall of the mountain there. So anyways, what I did want to do now is check out the traffic cars, which, of course, first we got to get in the Kenworth box truck. Which, this one's different than the one that was in, Horizon 1. This one is one that's actually, this one's actually still in Forza today. I think they might have had this one in... They might have had this one in Forza Horizon 3. I'm not sure, though. Oh, no. They might have had this in Horizon 3, but I'm not sure. But I know this is the one that they use in Horizon 4. Just different, like, license plate placement and all that. So next one here are the Ford Ka, which makes this technically the last game where you can drive a Ford Ka. I actually really wish these tiny little cars were still in. I I mean, I know now we have, like, even tinier cars, like the, you know, obviously, like, the BMW I said at a BMW 50. These little city cars, though, I do kind of wish we still had them. I mean, because especially upgraded, they're kind of fun to just play around with, the tiny little city cars. I mean, me mom's car. Boom, boom. Get out me car. Aww. That would have been great if that was actually filmed with a Ford car. Ooh, a Volkswagen Fox. Oh, coot. Funny story, in case you might know, Volkswagen was not in, Horizon 3 because, like, that's when they got caught cheating the emissions with, I think it was, like, the 1.9 or the 2-liter, it was, like, one of, like, the 4-cylinder TDI engines. They got caught cheating emissions, which unfortunately killed off TDI as a whole. And they're like, oh, now we're committing to electric and we're dropping from all motorsports unless it's going to be an electric car. And yeah, it's so stupid. But I remember, like, it was with Nick's Let's Play on it. In the background of, like, the opening to a race, in the background, there was, like, a little fox running across the road, and he was like, oh, look, a fox, and I was like, wait, there's no Volkswagen in this game, and I just feel embarrassed to admit that right now, but yeah, I actually thought he was talking about the Volkswagen. Alright, Ford Transit, we drove that bus, 2012, bus. Boss. It's a boss. Yeah, this is what I mean by, like, V6 being, like, the default sound. Because I'm pretty sure that this thing has a diesel on it, so. Oh, yeah, I forgot to get the little decal on the side. For some reason. Go off floating in a bus. Aw. Bus rally. Ow. Clipping point. Stop just in time, buddy. In your little Brera. Ooh, the Punto Evo Sport. Yeah, because in, we do have a drivable Punto in this game. But it's not the Fiat Punto. It's the Abarth Punto. I enjoy both of them. I keep thinking like, hey, let's turn into the Dots. And I'm like, no, wait, we can't. That's like, I think the biggest downside with this game is I don't have the Dots. But what we are going to check out after this has the Dots. Kind of. Oh, we got a little Yaris. We got a little Yaris. Oh, Yaris. Yeah, I like how, because, like, Toyota's coming out with that, like, GR Yaris, that one where it's, like, wide-body, all-wheel drive, turbo, three-cylinder. I really like how they actually listen to that petition and they're actually going to be bringing that to the US, like the RSGR. Because I think the original plans were Europe. I just wish Ford would do the same for the Mach-E, like listen to what people want, you know. Wait, what the fuck? What the fuck? Why can't I drive in here? Last time I checked in the Xbox One version, that's just like a garage door there. Why can't I drive in there? Alright, yeah, Fiesta Z-Tech, we checked out the non-traffic version. LA. We got the A200. Ooh. This thing's still a traffic car in Horizon today. Oh, this one's loud. Loud by traffic car standards. Yeah, that thing's loud by it. Like, compared to the rest of the traffic cars, that thing's loud. Okay, Volkswagen Bora VR6. Now, something I did realize about this thing, which the Bora is the Jetta, right? Like, the Bora is just a Jetta. Well, one thing, I do like a little bit of detail. The thing actually does sound like a VR6. But that little V6 badge on the back, that was actually by Volkswagen. Which makes me wonder if Volkswagen really knows their own engine. Because... because in case you don't know, the VR6 is not actually a V6. Like, apparently the R in VR6 is inline, like in German. So basically in English, the thing is a VI6, even though, yes, the thing is still called a VR6, yes. Like, if Volkswagen was a, was like an American or a British country, it would probably be called like the VI6. But yeah, this thing's not actually a V6, it's a VR6, because VR6 like, isn't just the name of the engine. That's the, like, that's actually the cylinder layout of the engine. Like, if you look up VR6 block, you would see that it's like two rows of three cylinders. But, like, in the construction of an inline engine. So the thing is technically a V inline engine. They probably just stuck V6 on this car because a lot of people just buying like the V6 version of a car probably don't exactly know what VR6 means. Oh yeah, that little bit of audio issue there, that actually happens on this sometimes. Yeah, that's probably why it says V6. Oh, the C32 AMG. Supercharged V6, right? Supercharged V6 on this one. Sound issues. I swear that's not me, guys. That's the actual game. I like the C32. I wish the C32 was still drivable. It is drivable in Motorsport, but not in Horizon. Ooh, Subaru Legacy. Oh my god, they actually put the Subaru sounds on this. They actually put the Subaru sounds on that. In the 2004 S4. Oh. Okay, now, before we end off today's episode, there is something I do want to check out. So let's head back to Xbox Home really quick. Because I'm sure you saw in my games. Oh yeah, by the way, that will be at some point. I have the Fast and Furious thing on here. Which I never went and got on to one because I didn't really see a point after I already played it on here. Now that, I actually think, does use the Xbox 360's graphics. But yeah, this, so I'm pretty much just going on here just to, like, look at... Again, if you want to see all differences between these two games... Oh, it's actually around here. Okay. If you want to see, like, all of the differences, I recommend going and watching Nick's videos that he covered on these, like, a while back, actually. Alright, let's get into the Charger RT here. You know what? No. Let's get into GDR. So, yeah, I'm ruining, of course. I'm pretty much just going on here because we're going to look at, you know, what the dock looks like. Okay, well, first of all, I don't know why we never got this car in the full game. I'm talking about, like, full game on the Xbox One. I'm not sure why we didn't get the GTR. They probably figured... I forgot, this had a different soundtrack. They probably figured it was, like, too similar to a regular GTR or something. No. Probably something stupid. This thing does have it similar. Because the docks are open on this. Because the docks are actually part of the story on this, so... So you can actually drop down into them. Because, I mean, they probably cut out the docks on the main game just because, like, to cut down on, you know, to cut down on assets. But, like, you see, like, there's not really much you can go here. You can go throughout most of these. There's like some roads here, you got the airport. So like, but a lot of this whole center, like even again the golf course and all that, and also of course like most of the map over there and all that, is all like blocked off. So yeah, they already cut down on assets. They were actually able to open stocks. So I'm assuming that the docks were probably planned for the 360 version, then they had to cut down on assets. That would explain why all those are here. Like these random things on the left now. But I'm assuming that this is what the docks were gonna be like if we actually didn't have them. Okay, well, first thing I've never checked over here is, does this have a little glitch? No, it doesn't have it. It does have this jump, though, which the game doesn't like very much. Yeah, the game doesn't like it very much. Yeah, the docks you see is like mostly the same, kind of. There's definitely some stuff missing. It's mostly the same, except for when you come up onto the crates here. When you come up onto the crates, can't just freely go on the crates, it's like rows. Like, it's like rows you can drive down, you can't just freely go up on them. This one. Like, right there, it's just a row, so you can't just freely go up on them, which makes it much more expensive than the one version. Okay, that was a nice one. This is just a low. Stop! Oh yeah, so you see you didn't have like the little thing over here that you can like ride on the side of, like it's all just like wall here. You don't have like a little slope thing here. This isn't very free, like this you can only... Oh, this you can actually free. Wait, so what's the point of the fences then? But like this, like see this is like the only spot we can actually drive freely on the plates here. I really don't understand this. I mean, you would think it would be more assets to put all these crates here, so I don't know why... can't really explore on the crates. But like right here, this isn't a jump, it's just like a little bridge. Up into here and then like you're on a roll again. This game does not like jumps very much. But then I feel like the most unique thing about the docks here though is if you head over onto like the little thing here, which first of all it's mapped on the map, so that's something that the one doesn't have. But second off, wait, no. I'm driving the wrong area. But yeah, it is mapped on the map though. It's, yeah, you see it, it's like mapped on the map. That's not mapped on the map in the one. Which makes sense, I think they wanted people to like explore it and all that, so. The water does not look bad. Way too tight. So yeah, it's all fine at first. But then you're just driving down it and it's just like, yeah, I really, okay, that was kind of sick, but I really don't know what causes that to actually happen. It just happens. Oh, I'm trying to do a clean donut around this one. But anyways, I think that's where we're going to leave this off here. I think that's where we're going to leave off a look at the, yes, is where we're going to leave off a look at the Xbox 360 version of Horizon 2. I hope you enjoyed it. It's a surprisingly good port for what it is. Of course, not very polished at all. But it's pretty solid, though. I think it's pretty solid. Wait, why can't I change my view? Hold on. What was the button to change view on this? Hold on. Why is it not right bumper? Oh, it's pressing down on the right stick. That's stupid. But yeah, anyways, I hope you enjoyed and I'll see ya.